tell you about myself. I'm a single mom that's been married so many times. I have the Reverend on speed dial. Who's next? My daughter used to buy Father's Day gifts in bulk at Costco because she never knew when I was going to bring home a stray. If one of my marriages lasted longer than 18 months, it was Brown City Commonwealth Church, as a true miracle has happened. I used to suffer from hemorrhoids until I found the greatest cure, divorce. I used to live in a trailer park, and you know you live in a trailer park when your morning ritual includes lifting the hood of your car to see if there's a stray cat or skunk curled up to your motor. And there's a special thing to do if you find a stray skunk curled up to your motor. Just leave it there. But I have a trailer park record for distance. I made it all the way to Save On Foods with a raccoon in the backseat. And when I got to Save On Foods, he gave me his grocery list. Who knew those things like cherry flavored pop tarts? And in the trailer park, we were very status conscious. Our definition of a Cadillac was a 1972 Pinto with two notching doors and a bumper. And if you're really classy, we had a park bench as a back seat. And instead of brakes or a gas pedal, most cars just had a hole in the floor. It would work for the Flintstones and it was for us. And in the park at night, the coyotes would eat ducks and pets or rabbits. That's just because they couldn't afford nachos and cheese at 7-Eleven. And in the trail park, the coyotes would howl almost as much as the drunks did. And they sounded a lot like two. The only difference is the coyotes were on pitch. Living in the trail park meant you never knew what kind of wildlife you would see. Deers, coyotes, the drunk neighbors driving up your driveway. I can tell you that the stereotype that you hear about the trail park is 100% true. There's a man that lived in the park that we called Moses because he walked around in his bathrobe every morning and he tried to park the duck pond. We used to hate it when the camping season came and the city folks would come and camp in trailers with microwaves, stoves, surround sound TVs, and they thought they were roughing it. Their idea of deprivation was having no Wi-Fi. And there's an order in the RV park. Snob Row, where the singles lived with no kids or retired ones. Bingo Alley, where the mom spent all day and all night at the bingo hall. And then there was Beer Alley. That speaks for itself. And in the RV park, there was also a wild bird sanctuary. And we would get about 200 ducks. Most stayed there all year round. But you never had been woken up till you had a duck crash into your metal roof. I guess it spent too much time in Beer Alley. Like I said, we had about 200 ducks. And we never worried till one day we saw a KFC truck pull up with a net. Living in the trail park, I can tell you how to deep fry a turkey, soak it in gasoline, and light it with a match. And there were cows everywhere. We were eating one night, and one of them came into the trailer, pointed out at Burke, and said, "Hey, that's my cousin." To get the cows moving, you had to find the elk cow. She was pretty easy to spot. She was the one smoking the cigarette and carrying the AK-47. And in the mall, you're often asked, where's the washrooms or the Toys R Us are? As a plus-size woman, the only question I'm asked is, where's the Dairy Queen? that I'm big, so they figure I know how to cook. So they ask the questions like, how do I cook this roast? So forget about it. I just say stuff like, leave it out for 3 days, slather it with cream cheese, and eat it raw.